Fido's mission is to help our community through the use of specially trained dogs.
Fidos for Freedom trains two types of assistance dogs. We train service dogs for the mobility impaired. That could be anyone from that's in a wheelchair, a walker, and we also train the hearing dogs. It's for a person that's either deaf or hard of hearing, and they become their ears and they alert them to all the different sounds in their environment.
Fidos has many different kinds of breeds that we use in our assistance dog program. We have Goldens, we have Labs, we have smooth-coated Collies, we have some Poodles, we have some smaller dogs like Boo Huns, we've had Corgis in the past. So we have many different types of breeds.
I'm Pat Jarvis. I'm the director of training at Fidos for Freedom. Our training department is responsible for selecting and training the puppies from the time they're as young as 8 weeks old through the time of matching with an eligible client. What that involves is selecting the puppies by testing the puppies that have the aptitude to do this sort of work, and nurturing the puppies by placing them in a puppy raiser's home.
This is a volunteer who takes that puppy into their home and teaches them basic stuff, basic things like sit, stay, down, come when called, walk on a loose lead. They also teach them how to eliminate on command. They teach them to live in their kennels. The puppies go with the volunteer puppy raisers. For about a year, they live in a puppy raiser's home. And then when the training staff thinks it's time to move that puppy into a home of a trainer, the puppy goes into a trainer's home, and from that time on, they reinforce all the basic stuff, but then they teach them the specific skills, whether the dog's going to be a hearing assistance dog or a service dog.
We spend a lot of time teaching the dogs, but then we also spend a lot of time teaching the client how to handle the dog. That's the other aspect of the training program, is we also train people.
Not your dog didn't go up to the person. The person's coming to your dog, but yet you're correcting your dog. What kind of a signal is that sending to your dog? Think about it. That's not what you want to do to your dog.
Usually it takes approximately 2 years to train one of our dogs. And we don't like to place them until they're at least 2 years old because we don't feel that they're mentally stable enough to be out there working and to grow up enough to be out there in the public eye until they're 2 years old.
Somewhere between 20 and 24, 26 months, the training staff will match that dog with one of our clients.
When a dog I have trained is successfully matched with a client and really makes an impact on their life, it's a very rewarding feeling.
I absolutely have loved Derby since I've been training with him and have prayed that this would be the dog that I would get.
My name is Denise Portis, and this is my hearing assistance dog, Chloe, and she also does balance assist work. Before Fidos for Freedom, I was a lot more dependent on my family. And I realized I'd become so dependent on them, I was really worried about, well, what am I going to do when they're gone? And it was because of that that I knew a dog could give me independence. I'm a school teacher, so we arrive at school pretty early in the morning, and Chloe just attends all my classes with me. My students drop pencils and papers on purpose so that she'll come over and pick up their things because they think that's really cool. And she loves to do it. She loves to work and she's friendly with everyone. So she interacts with my students and co-teachers really well.
My name is Sandy and I'm Director of Client Services here at Fidos for Freedom. I am also a client. Fidos has impacted my life in many different ways. First, the dog and how he helps me be independent, but also it's a group, it's like a family. When I started applying for the dog and coming for training, then I built up a group of friends here, and now they're my closest friends.
Okay, do we want to go around just a couple more times?
Fidos has a huge impact on a lot of the members of the community, specifically one of the folks that get assistance dogs from us. These dogs change people's lives. They make our clients much more independent. The larger picture in our community is when the therapy dogs go out and our handlers share those therapy dogs with people in hospitals.
We have a huge therapy dog program. We have about 300 volunteers, and we have about 35 different facilities that we visit on a regular basis here in Maryland.
We have a program for our junior volunteers, kids that are 12 to 17. They come, they get their community service hours, they learn about people with disabilities. We also have a program called DEAR, Dogs Educating and Assisting Readers. Our volunteers take their dogs and they share them with students who have been selected by the teachers in the schools. It helps them get their reading skills in better shape.
What I see for the future of Fidos isn't necessarily a geographic expansion, but I do see an expansion in the different things that a dog can do to help people.